In the first step, we learned that the root cause of our unhealthy aging is the mismatch of our old genes and our environment. In the second step, we learned how the current medical system is acting as a medical reflex after the crash. We've come to look at age-related diseases as something that we should prevent. But how? In this step, we will first look at current preventive measures that focus on a conscious, rational decision model. We will discuss how health decisions are made and discuss how much of our health behavior is unconscious and driven by the environment. What do you think? Do you think it is possible to change your lifestyle? Changing your lifestyle is notoriously difficult. Some even think it is impossible. Now, I don't think it is impossible, but I do think we have to take a completely different approach. We've been told for 30 years what we should do and what we should not do to remain healthy up to higher ages. Eat more vegetables, eat less sugar, less salt, less fat, less calories, exercise more, stop smoking. It's no secret that all of these things help. Some studies have calculated that theoretically, over 90% of cases of myocardial infarction can be prevented by a healthy lifestyle. The tricky part is to maintain the healthy behavior in the long term by integrating it into daily routine. We've been told what to do, but our bodies don't want to and never will. And we now understand why. They were never evolved, never designed to do so. Sugar will always taste good. We can try to control our body with our brain by telling it not to eat too much chocolate every day, but this is not very fun, nor very effective, especially in the long run. That's why diets don't work. I mean, they work great, if you actually follow them. Research has shown that all diets work. The effect does not really depend on the type of diet. You will lose weight with diets that tell you to eat less sugar, with diets that tell you to eat less fat, less carbohydrate, less protein, etc. But none of them works in the long run. After 1 year, the majority of people is back at their original weight, plus the half kilo that we all gain every year. Diets don't work because they are an example of trying to change the behavior of your body with your brain. Mark Twain already said it in one sentence. The only way to keep your health is to eat what you don't want, drink what you don't like, and do what you'd rather not. In this step, we consider an alternative approach to health promotion. We will look at how our brains make health decisions and how unconscious processes and triggers are important in this. We will also learn to identify these triggers or nudges in your own environment. In the assignment, you will collect photos of the triggers from your own daily environments and contribute to our worldwide databank of obesity nudges that nudge us to unhealthy behavior and eventually drive our unhealthy aging process.